What up, guys? So yes, I had a busy day. I got home late. I had to do my yard work. Pretty much didn't sleep till past midnight. And I got my ass up exactly at 5:55 a.m. It's 7:25 a.m. right now. Fresh day, 7:25 a.m. So I took my pre-workout, woke up, and my goals for the rest of the 30 days, I really have to start dieting. That's my main thing. That's my main weakness right now. And I got to start reading more. So what I'm going to do, I've probably been going over 2,000. So I'm going to try to bring it right below 2,000, around 1,600, 1,700 calories. So you guys will be seeing me count my calories. And the only macro I'm going to count is my, I'm going to keep it high protein. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to have a shake or a double scoop after my workout. And I'm not going to eat but once a day. And if I get a little hungry, a can of tuna. And so I'll be counting my calories like that. And I'll be looking at my carbs. I'll be making my carbs low, and I'm going to add cardio, double up. So either hot yoga or cardio or even triple up. And I'm having a very, very busy month. So I just want to tell you guys how important the wake up time is. Sometimes you have to sacrifice sleep. You have to be on your time management like the fuck. And that's another thing I could kind of work out. I just naturally do it good because I'm used to being very busy. 6 hours. Sometimes you got to get 5 to 6 hours. You just have to make that sacrifice. If you can squeeze in a 20 minute nap, do so. Look in my eyes. They're not that bad, but they get bad. Sunday has to be, you got to choose one day to sneak that rest in. So you're only really struggling 5 days, not struggling, but your body gets used to it. So you'll pop up. But that Sunday, you got to, your rest day, you have to sleep in and you have to get to bed early. So you catch up on sleep. You can sleep 10 hours that day. Still getting on average 8 hours, you know, if you want to, but really you don't need to, you know, you don't need to sleep that much of your life. Yeah, I'll get more into that. I know a lot about those things as you know, I haven't told you guys, but I used to be 270 plus. I got down to 205, probably even less than 205. That's just when I decided to scale myself. I'll scale myself like once a month, you know? Yeah. So when I started this, you guys saw that I was at 225. Been able to keep it off for the most part because, you know, as a kid, I've gained weight, got thin, you know. I'm 27 now. I probably around 24 is when I did. So about the last 3 years, I've been pretty consistent on keeping my weight off. Over the last 2 years, though, I've been in a relationship that's kind of, the first year was easy, you know. The last two has kind of been, my diet has been on and off, you know, because when you're going out eating, doing all that stuff, it's pretty tough. But I'm going to show you guys it's possible. You guys don't have to be eating chicken and rice every day unless that's what you want. Those are the goals you want. For me, I'm trying to get down to like 15% body fat. And I'm going to do it with you guys and build some muscle. And let's see how this goes. So here's my first meal of the day, and you see I'm gonna throw one scoop in there. It has 120 calories and you got 3 grams of carbs. There's the proteins and there's the fats. You guys want to track your macros, that's how you do them. Then I'm gonna throw a cup of this in there and some Folgers caffeine, which you don't count that. So right here you got, I'm gonna look at the total carbohydrates, which is 6 grams and 120 calories. So this protein shake is gonna cost me 240 calories, 6 and 3 grams and 9 grams. So 240, 9 grams. This whole drink right here, I put 8 ounces of milk, threw some ice in there, put a scoop of protein and some Folgers right here. Boom. It's like a protein coffee shake for the morning, you know what I mean? Just remember, you gotta remind yourself when you're in a calorie deficit so that when your stomach is growling or hurting, you're not starving. That's your stomach digesting your food. That's your digestive system working. If you fast for like 2 days, you'll probably still be shitting by the second day.